What up, YouTube? Today's video, I want to talk about messengers being sent in your path. Now, a few days ago, right, I was walking to the store with somebody, right, and the most abnormal thing happened. Well, it's really not abnormal to me, but to the average mind, it would be weird, abnormal, peculiar. You know what I'm saying? Obscure, you know, things of that nature. You know what I'm saying? You know, just stuff that people not used to. But me, I have experiences like this before, but this one was on a different level, right? Like I was saying, I was walking to the store with somebody, and as we was walking, you know, me, I'm peeping my surroundings everywhere I go. You know what I'm saying? I'm looking around. You know what I'm saying? I'm just peeping the scene. That's just how I am. So as I'm peeping the scene, it's like, the way we walking, you look to the left, it's like an alley. You look straight, you see down the street. You look right, you can go that way. But as you look right, you can see the store we walk into as well. So it's like three ways you can go. You know what I'm saying? So I look left, I see some dude walking through the alley or whatever, right? And you know me, I'm, you know, being prejudiced, you know what I'm saying? Like, everybody prejudiced, which is prejudice means prejudging somebody before you get to know them. I'm thinking it's finna be a problem, you know what I'm saying? I'm thinking this person's finna cause trouble. I don't even know this person. I'm just going off body language and, you know, appearance of what the person got on. You know, dude had on all red, you know what I'm saying? And I'm looking like, oh, yeah, this nigga probably finna be a problem. But me, you know, I kept my composure. You see what I'm saying? You know, being cool. So we in the store, you know what I'm saying? And we buying something from the store or whatever, right? And the dude come in. And he buys something from the store. But as he buys something from the store, he get to talking to us. He like, yeah, I'm going to break something down to y'all. And I'm going to only break it down to y'all because I can see through y'all soul. I can see y'all good people. You see what I'm saying? And I'm like, whoa. So then after he say that, he like, Jesus coming back and he not white. So after he said that, I just got to cracking up laughing. You know what I'm saying? He like, no, I'm dead serious. I'm like, I know you serious. That's why I'm laughing. You see what I'm saying? And I'm like, it's crazy that, you know, like, that you know this type of stuff. Because a lot of people, you know, in this area, you know what I'm saying? Just a lot of people in the world, they just don't know about this type of stuff. And he like, yeah, Jesus coming back and he not going to be white. And he was like, yeah, black people, you know, melanated people, the Moors, the Hebrews, not no Israelites, but the Hebrews, you know what I'm saying? We chosen people. He was like, yeah, black people, we the chosen people. He was like, we God chosen people. He was like, Jesus coming back to get his chosen people. He like, you know, we the tribe of Judah and stuff like that. And if you read the Bible, like I said, 50% of the Bible is truth. 50% of the Bible is lies. You know what I'm saying? The Bible is all allegories and stories, but it's all written in parables. Parables mean like double mean. It's like a double entendre, but it's like hints inside these things. That's why they say you must fast in order to, you know, peep what's going on in the Bible. And they say that because when you fast, you clean your system out, meaning you don't have any unnecessary chemicals from your food, you know what I'm saying, messing up your mind. You see what I'm saying? But me, I'm a different type of person. I always been spiritual and I always known it. You see what I'm saying? Well, I don't say I always known it. I always say at one point in time I was spiritual without being spiritual, but I always know I was spiritual, if that makes sense. You see what I'm saying? So me, I'm different. I could read the Bible and peep the scenes. That's because that's just who I am. You see what I'm saying? I'm a life path 33, which is rare for somebody's birthday to equal the number 33. You see what I'm saying? 1-8-1995. You add all that up together, 1 plus 8 plus 1 plus 9 plus 9 plus 5. Equals 33. You see what I'm saying? Life path 33. So he was saying all this type of stuff. He was like, yeah, why you think black people, we the most hated people on the planet? It's because we God chosen people. We the tribe of Judah. He was like, yeah. He was like, he coming back to save us. Woo, woo, woo. And you know me, like the average person gonna be, oh, that shit ain't real. Blah, blah, blah. Or some people just gonna see it on the Jesus part and all that type of stuff. You see? And he was like, yeah, it's proof in the Bible to let you know that Jesus was black and this, this, and that. And I'm like, yeah, I know what you're talking about. But like the average mind or the average so-called Christian, I'm not Christian. I'm not religious. I'm spiritual. It's a big difference. But, you know what I'm saying? Me, I know what he's saying. He's speaking in parables. He's speaking spirituality, basically saying that the fifth dimensional shift is happening. It's already happening. And the Most High is going to pick his chosen people, meaning the Most High is coming back, which the Most High is going to send multiple messengers back, a.k.a. Jesus, from your point of view, or if you're not spiritual, if you're one of them Christians, it's your point of view, you think it is Jesus, but the Most High of the universe is sending messengers back, such as me, to wake people up, take them to the fifth dimension. Now, like I said, how the fifth dimension is going to be, it's not going to be just some boom, magical shit. No, the fifth dimension is already happening. It's a shift in consciousness. It's a shift in DNA, DNA upgrades. That's what's called light codes, repairing your DNA, getting your memory back, right? Meaning like this, fifth dimension, better days, you know what I'm saying, brighter things, you know, more success, stuff like that. It's like 3D, 5D. If you're stuck in 3D, that means right now you have a chance to get out, probably. Because, you know, Earth been splitting since 2013. But you still have a chance to get out if you want a certain amount of light codes. But what I mean by people being stuck in 3D, like the Brethren, the 13th Son, you know, Sister Aphrodite Stone, you know, RFG, you know, people like that, Ralph Smart, you know, Infinite Waters, Diving Deep, man, Flirt Burn, there's just so many people that's breaking this down. Nature Boy, I fuck with him too, shout out him. He be dropping that real ether, you know what I'm saying? But and many other people that's dropping that real knowledge. But you know what I'm saying? Basically, when I say you're going to be stuck in the third dimension, that means you're going to be stuck in hell. Hell, we already living in hell, right? Meaning you're going to be stuck in the shit, your current situation. Meaning you're going to be stuck in violence. You're going to be stuck in poverty. You're going to be stuck in drugs. You're going to be stuck in sex. You know what I'm saying? You're going to be stuck in this shit. Meaning you can't get out. I mean, you're in the third dimension. You're going to be recycling. When they mean recycle, when you pass away and you die and you go back into that light, being sucked back into the matrix, you're going to grow up into this shit all over again. It's going to be a constant cycle. It means you're trapped. And even if you still live, that means you're going to be trapped, meaning you can't get out of that cycle that you're in anymore because you never upgraded your DNA to get to the fifth dimension. Now, on the fifth dimensional side, and me, all this stuff is going to happen on this planet. It's just going to be a shift, meaning the people who rise up to the fifth dimension will be on the same planet as the 3D people, but they will not be around 3D people. Basically meaning that people who make it to 5D, which is the fifth dimension, which is heaven on earth, because in order to see heaven up there, you must achieve heaven up here. As above, so below. You see what I'm saying? Wake the damn up. So basically it's like this, right? People who make it to 5D, they will be successful. They will see brighter days. They have positivity around them. Everything in their life will be positive. Everything in their life will be beautiful. It won't be no negative vibrations. It won't be no negative thoughts. Everything will be positive. You see what I'm saying? Everything will be getting better for those people because they're in the fifth dimension. Just off thought, things will manifest. You see what I'm saying? But if you're stuck in 3D, all the stuff that you're going through now with the violence and all that evil shit, you're stuck in that. That's the difference between 3D and 5D. So just for that guy out the blue to just come up and say all that, you know what I'm saying? That's how I know this shit real. You know what I'm saying? That's just the Most High. Let me know, give me clarification that I'm on the right path and this shit is real. And let me tell you the crazy part about this, right? After he said all that type of stuff, he walked away. He left out the store, right? After he said, yeah, we God's chosen people, you know, the tribe of Judah, you know what I'm saying, all this type of stuff. He had left, but we were still in the store. But guess what? It wasn't even 30 seconds that we was in the store, right? And no, I told you, when we first seen the dude, he was walking down the alley on the left side. Because I said, when you walk up, you can either go the left way, right way, or go straight down the street. He was coming down the alley from the left side, right? So he left out. And like I said, it wasn't even 30 seconds after we left behind him. It wasn't even 30 seconds. As soon as we walked outside, this dude was gone, disappeared, vanished, Spanguli, whatever you want to say, gone. That's how I know that was an angel. That basically was the universe or the Most High or Jesus, Allah, Buddha, whatever name you go by. I like to say the universe and the Most High, but that was the universe sending me clarification, letting me know I'm on the right path, sending a messenger to me to let me know that you're on the right path. You see what I'm saying? And I'm telling you, we walked outside, wasn't even 30 seconds after we left behind him, gone, looking every way. Dude got on all red. Come on, if you see somebody with all red, you'd be able to see him down the street. He was nowhere to be found. That was an angel. You see what I'm saying? So I'm telling you, this is real shit that's going on. Messages being sent back in your life to let you know what's happening. And you get be, and don't get it wrong, like I said, you know, I'm just using this word, but you know, God's people have a spiritual revolution and Satan's people have a spiritual revolution. You see what I'm saying? So you can get evil messengers sent to you to help you work for the dark lords of the universe. You see what I'm saying? So I'm just telling you, wake the damn up. This stuff is real, man. It can't get no more spiritual than that. If you're not experiencing spiritual things, because you're not on that vibration to experience spiritual things, this shit is real, like real talk. Like, it can't get no more weirder than that. You know what I'm saying? So this is real spiritual message. Wake the damn up that way.